Hi everyone, welcome to my new video about the two busiest train stations in the city of Cologne, Germany. You're watching the Post Metro channel, my name is Evgeny Matusov, and today I'm going to show you how a large construction project will soon expand both of these stations for an improved, more frequent service of S-Bahn, the commuter train system of this famous city with more than 1 million inhabitants. But first of all, let me explain something in Russian to my regular viewers before they get scared off hearing me speak English all of a sudden. Друзья мои, уважаемые подписчики, не пугайтесь, что я начал это видео на английском, и никуда не уходите. Один клик, и вы можете включить субтитры на русском языке. Я их делал и проверял сам, так что ручаюсь, что там все правильно. А я попробую все-таки немного расширить аудиторию канала, учитывая нынешнюю ситуацию с YouTube. The S-Bahn system of Cologne, or Köln, how I like to call the city the German way, consists of five routes, which all come together in one place to cross the Rhine River between the two stations on each bank. The Köln Hauptbahnhof, or the main train station on the west bank, and the Cologne Fair, or Deutz, station on the east bank. The river crossing happens over the famous bridge. Its name is Hohenzollernbrücke. Not so easy to pronounce, is it? Anyway, you don't have to remember the name of the bridge. It is remembered and visited by many for the tens of thousands of locks that freshly married couples decorate it with. According to some estimates, there are already 500,000 locks on the fences on both sides of the bridge, where people walk on pedestrian pathways. This tradition is said to have come from Italy in the early 2000s. Probably by now half of these couples are not even married anymore, but their names are still here on these rusty locks. Some people now even hang a lock with a four-digit code that you can go and remove in the case of a divorce. And if you think there are many locks, you haven't seen the other southern side of the bridge where I didn't go this time. There you can't see the fence anymore, it's just a wall of locks. But back to the bridge itself and its use for S-Bahn. The bridge itself is a pretty old one, built between 1907 and 1911. Originally, it had three adjacent bridge parts, each with three iron truss arches in the longitudinal direction to accommodate for four railway tracks and a road. After World War II, the southern bridge part with the road was torn down, so only the four railway tracks remained. Soon these were not enough to handle the increasing passenger traffic, in particular the many long-distance trains, including high-speed ones, intercity express trains, which appeared in the 80s. But also regional express trains and since the 70s also the S-Bahn commuter trains. So in the 80s a third section of the bridge was built again with two additional tracks. Its style is exactly the same as the style of the two original sections, but the new section is much lighter. This allowed for the tracks to be put on a bed of ballast, reducing the noise from the passing trains. This construction happened between 1985 and 1989, this time on the north side of the original bridge. Since then, S-Bahn trains started rolling over this bridge in regular intervals, each line or route every 20 minutes on a workday, which meant intervals of 5 minutes or less here on the bridge for all the routes combined.
Дизельный вообще идет, но входит в систему S-Bahn официально. Интересно.
Yes, one regional diesel train route also uses the S-Bahn tracks here somehow, terminating just one stop to the west of the main train station. But what you're looking at right now is the Cologne Fair or Deutz station, where multiple routes merge together on one track, from Düsseldorf or from the south, including the airport of Köln-Bonn. The other way to describe it is that they fork to the east from the track in the opposite direction, here on the right. The Deutz station and the main train station are just the Rhine River and a few hundred meters apart, but both of them are major transfer hubs with many tracks. And this is part of the problem with the S-Bahn here. The two S-Bahn tracks are served by only one platform that is quite narrow, yet trains here stop every 3 or 4 minutes in each direction. A lot of people want to get out of the train here or into a train, not only because they want to transfer to a long distance or another regional train, but also because there are many places of interest here in the Köln city center, places where people have jobs and commute to every day. During rush hour, often 1 minute or even 2 minutes is not enough time to let everyone in and out of an S-Bahn train. Obviously, this regularly causes delays, which are very hard to overcome when the train schedule is so tight. Of course, the local and federal government, as well as Deutsche Bahn, the German railways, know about this problem. As early as 2010, it was decided that an additional platform with two tracks should be built on each side of the river to solve the capacity issue. Yet now we are in 2024 and the construction has still not started. However, it is finally supposed to start this year or next year, which is why I'm making this video. The optimistic timeline for finishing the project is until 2030. Here is what makes the project especially interesting. The government does not want to spend a lot of money and time for building another two-track bridge section over the Rhine River. There is enough space for it, but most experts seem to believe that it is not necessary, that the two-track S-Bahn bridge section is not such a small eye of a needle as it seems to be. After the construction is finished, each direction will be served by two tracks with a platform in between. This means that passengers would be able to get on and off the trains, which go in the same direction, in parallel, at the same time. Then, to cross the bridge, the two tracks would merge into one shortly and then would fork again, after the bridge, into two tracks on the other side. It is estimated that with the modern signaling systems, it is possible to run 24 trains an hour over the bridge in one direction, which is a train every 2.5 minutes. Compare this to the current maximum capacity of 18 trains per hour. But this would only be possible if the on-off boarding process of two consecutive trains at least partially overlaps in time. And of course, the additional track for each direction at both the fare and the main Cologne stations would allow a delayed train to pass another train, which means that any delays of a single train would have less effect on the other trains which use this busiest track section. Another interesting thing about the project is that Germans, who always like to plan everything well in advance, actually made provisions in the previous not even years but decades for this project to happen as smoothly as possible, with little interruption to the current S-Bahn service. This elevated track, for example, already back in the 80s was built with this stub here, not sure how to call it, but basically with the possibility to install a switch to another track that would be later built nearby. And now, 30 or more years later, this stub will finally be used, so it means that it has not been built in vain. Also, see this arch here at the main train station near its north entrance? This was built around 10 years ago, and in the future, the poles supporting this canopy will be in the middle of the new platform, with a track on each side where S-Bahn trains would be heading west. I know it does not look like it, but according to this official project plan, there is enough space here, and also the roof of the entrance to the subway that you see here on the right. This roof has been built already, accounting for the future elevated platform and tracks, so that it would later be adjacent to them. After the new platform is constructed, both tracks of the existing platform would be used only by S-Bahn trains going east towards the bridge. Here's what I said about it in Russian when preparing this video.
Вот это задел под ответвление на еще одну платформу для S-Bahn'а с Хоенцоллернбрюке, то есть вот с этого знаменитого Кёльнского моста. На мосту остаются два пути для S-Bahn'а, потому что мост никак не расширить, но будет по одной посадочной платформе с двумя путями в каждом направлении, чтобы можно было параллельно осуществлять посадку и высадку, и тем самым уменьшить интервалы на этом пути, даже если все равно остается такое игольное ушко в виде этого моста. И вот здесь в дальнейшем будет построена еще одна платформа. Под нее есть задел в виде вот такого козырька, который окажется в середине этой платформы, его опоры. И будут накрывать они как раз платформу и новые пути, а сама платформа начнется немножко дальше, чем вот платформа, на которой я стою, в ту сторону. Вот такой задел здесь оставили под улучшение транспортной ситуации, уменьшение интервалов. Иначе просто поезда не успевают осуществлять посадку и высадку и тормозятся при интервалах меньше 3 минут или 4 минут. А именно такие маленькие интервалы, 4-5 минут, сейчас есть на Кёльнском S-Bahn'е в утренние часы пик, в будние дни. Thank you.
A similar thing is planned on the east bank of the river, where the two tracks coming from the bridge would become four. There is enough space for another platform here between the existing platform and the buildings of the Köln Messe, the Cologne Fair. Here below you see the two tracks of the high-speed line, on which ICE trains come from Düsseldorf, stop here and then continue on to Frankfurt, or vice versa. Hopefully, the new S-Bahn platform will have a better transfer to this high-speed train line with escalators and elevators. Many Germans who made comments during the public hearing of the proposed expansion project were really angry that currently you have to go down several flights of stairs to get from the existing S-Bahn platform to board an ICE train, and there is no elevator here, at least not on this platform end. And since in the last few years the German railways have become notorious for constant delays and train cancellation, which is a whole other sad story, it often happens that you miss a connection, say to Frankfurt, at the main train station, and then you have to ride an S-Bahn train for one stop to Deutz, leaving the famous beautiful cathedral with two towers behind your back, and at Deutz station you get out and run with your suitcases to catch a high-speed train. Be aware of this if you ever travel to Cologne in these days. As part of the construction soon to be started, the current platforms should also be modernized. The total cost of the project is estimated with 60 million euros, but I'm sure this amount will be significantly exceeded, because it always happens like that with large construction projects in Germany. Now, if something was not clear, if you have questions about the projects, I am happy to answer them in the comments section. You might have one particular question when now I am going to show to you the future S-Bahn development map with all the new routes and a few new stations, with all of this supposedly happening in 2030 plus. And you know, in Germany the plus may well mean 5 or 10 or 15 years, give or take. Just think of Stuttgart 21 if you know what I'm talking about. What you might ask when looking at this though is whether this next station to the west of Köln's main station would get another platform too. After all, if you look in the east, the S-Bahn lines start to fork immediately after the fair station, so no new tracks or platforms are really needed here. But in the west, at Köln-Hansaring, all the 24 trains per hour would still be on one track. But the answer is no, Köln-Hansaring will remain as you see it here, with just one platform and one track each way. I guess it was calculated that the number of passengers here is not as high, so that the trains stop only for some seconds instead of minutes here, not causing any delays, just like in a good and busy subway system. Well, let's wait and see what happens. I will continue covering this project in the future and will also have videos about Köln's S-Bahn and subway systems in general, so please subscribe and hit the bell not to miss anything. Also, please comment if you think that this project is a good idea or maybe not, and Germans should have invested in building another bridge. I'm curious about your opinion. Or maybe somewhere in your city there is an eye of a needle, like this bridge, where multiple routes come together and it needs to be expanded in a similar way. Please write about it. Hope you enjoyed this video and see you next time.